Well, I've been a journalist for about 25 years, and I was educated to lie, to betray, and not to tell the truth to the public. But seeing right now, within the last months, how the German and American media tries to bring war to the people in Europe, to bring war to Russia, this is a point of no return. And I'm going to stand up and say it is not right what I have done in the past to manipulate people, to make propaganda against Russia, and it is not right what my colleagues do and have done in the past, because they are bribed to betray the people, not only in Germany, all over Europe. The reason writing this book was that I am very fearful of a new war in Europe, and I don't like to have this situation again, because war is never coming from itself. There is always people behind it to push for war. And this is not only politicians, this is journalists too. And I just have written in the book how we have betrayed in the past our readers just to push for war, and because I don't want this anymore. I'm fed up with this propaganda. We live in a banana republic and not in a democratic country where we have press freedom, where we have human rights. If you see the German media, especially my colleagues who day by day write against the Russians, who are in transatlantic organizations and who are supported by the United States to do so, well, people like me, I became honorary citizen of the state of Oklahoma in the United States. Just why? Just because I write pro-American. I wrote pro-American. I was supported by the Central Intelligence Agency, by the CIA. Why? Because I should be pro-American. I'm fed up with it. I don't want to do it anymore. And so I've just written a book not to earn money. No, it will cause a lot of trouble for me, just to give the people in this country, in Germany, in Europe, and all over the world, just to give them a glimpse of a view what goes up behind the closed doors. Yes, there is many examples for that. If we go just back to history, if you go into the year 1988, if you go to your archives, you will find in March 1988 that there was in Iraq the Kurdish people have been gassed with poisoned gas. That is known all over the world. But in July 1988, they sent me to a town called Zubaydat, that is on the Iraqi-Iranian border. There was war. It was war between the Iranians and the Iraqis, and I was sent there to photograph how the Iranians have been gassed with poisoned gas, with German poisoned gas. You call it lost and zarin, mustard gas, made by Germany. They have been gassed, and I was there to make photographs how these people have been killed by poison gas from Germany. When I came back to Germany, there was just one small photo in a newspaper, in the Frankfurter Allgemeine, and there was one small article not writing how impressive, brutally, how unhuman, how terrible it was to kill decades after the end of the Second World War people with German poisoned gas. So this was a situation I feel misused for having been there, and just to give a documentary what has been done, but not being allowed to cry out to the world what we have done behind closed doors. Up to today, it's not well known in the public that was German public gas. There have been hundreds or thousands of people gassed in this city of Zubaydat. Now, you ask, what have I done for intelligence agencies? So please see, most of the journalists you see in foreign countries, they claim to be journalists, and they might be journalists, European or American journalists, but many of them, like me in the past, are so-called non-official cover. That's what the Americans call that. I have been a non-official cover. Non-official cover means what? It means you too work for an intelligence agency. You help them if they want you to help them, but they will never, never, when you are locked, or when they find out that you are not only a journalist but a spy too, they will never say, "Oh, this was one of our guys." They will not know you. That means non-official cover. So I have helped them in several situations, and I feel ashamed for that too now. Like I feel ashamed that I have worked for a very recommended newspaper like the Frankfurter Allgemeine, because I was bribed by billionaires, I was bribed by the Americans not to report exactly the truth. But I just imagined in my car while I was driving to this interview, I just tried to work out in my brain what would have happened if I would have written a pro-Russian article in the Frankfurter Allgemeine. Well, I don't know what would have happened, but we were all educated to write pro-European, pro-American, but please, not pro-Russian. So I'm very sorry for that, but this is not what I understand for democracy and for press freedom. I'm very sorry for that. Well, Yes, I understand your question very well. Germany is still a kind of a colony of the United States. You see that in many points, like the majority of the Germans don't want to have nukes in our country, but we still have American nukes. So we are still a kind of a colony of the Americans. And being a colony, it is very easy to approach young journalists through what is very important here is transatlantic organizations. All journalists from really respected and recommended big German newspapers, magazines, radio stations, TV stations, they are all members or guests of those big transatlantic organizations. And there, in these transatlantic organizations, you are approached to be pro-American. And there is nobody coming to you and saying, "Well, we are the Central Intelligence Agency. Would you like to work for us?" No, this is not the case how it happens. What they do, these transatlantic organizations, is they invite you. They invite you for seeing the United States. They pay for that. They pay all your expenses and everything. So you are bribed. You get more and more corrupt, because they make you good contacts. You won't know that those good contacts are, let's say, non-official covers, or officially people working for Central Intelligence Agency or other American agencies. So you make friends. You think they are friends, and you cooperate with them. They ask you, "Well, could you do me this favor? Could you do me that favor?" And so your brain more and more is brainwashed through these guys. And your question was, is this only the case with German journalists? No, I think it is especially the case with British journalists, because they have a much closer relationship. It is especially the case with Israelis, of course, with French journalists for a part, not that big as with German or with British journalists. It is the case for Australian journalists, for journalists from New Zealand, from Taiwan, from, well, there is many countries in the Arab world, like Jordan, for example, like Oman, the Sultanate of Oman. There is many countries where this happens, where you find people to claim they are respected journalists, but if you look behind them, you'll find they are puppets on a string of the Central Intelligence Agency. I'm sorry in interrupting you. I'll give you one example. Sometimes the intelligence agencies, they come to your office and want you to write an article. I give you an example not from strange other journalists, from me myself. I've just forgotten the year. I just remember that the German Foreign Intelligence, Bundesnachrichtendienst, it is just a sister organization of the Central Intelligence Agency. It was founded by the American Intelligence Agency. So one day, the BND, this German Foreign Intelligence Agency, came to my office at the Frankfurter Allgemeine in Frankfurt. And they wanted me to write an article about Libya and about Colonel Muammar Gaddafi. I had absolutely no secret informations regarding Colonel Muammar Gaddafi and Libya. But they gave me all these secret informations, and they just wanted me to write, to sign the article with my name. I did that, but it was an article that was published in the Frankfurt Allgemeine that originally came from the Bundesnachrichtendienst, from the German Foreign Intelligence Agency. So do you really think that this is journalism, intelligence agencies writing articles? Oh yes, that article, I have reprinted it partly in my book. That article was how Libya and Colonel Muammar Gaddafi, how he secretly tried to build a poison gas factory, I think in Rapta was the name, yeah. And I got all those informations. It was a story that was printed worldwide 2 days later. But I had no information on that. It was the intelligence agency that wanted me to write this article. So, but this is not the way journalism should work, that intelligence agencies, that they decide what is printed and what not. If I say no, I give you an example from a very good example if you say no. Well, we have a rescue unit in Germany with helicopters for traffic accidents. It's called, they call themselves the Yellow Angels. There was one guy who didn't want to cooperate. He was a pilot of the helicopter service of the Yellow Angels in Germany. This guy said no to the Foreign Intelligence Service, Bundesnachrichtendienst, when they approached him and wanted him as a non-official cover to work for the German Foreign Intelligence Agency, under, just to pretend to be somebody from the Yellow Angels. So what happened was that he lost his job. And the court in Germany, the judge decided that they were right, because such a guy could not be trusted. He was kicked off his job because he didn't cooperate with the Foreign Intelligence Service. So I knew what would happen if I would not cooperate with intelligence services. Well, I have had, let me say, one, two, six times my house was house searched because I was accused by the public prosecutor, the German public prosecutor. I was accused of leaking secrets of states. Six times house searched. Well, they hoped that I wouldn't do that ever again. But I think it's worse that the truth will come out one day. The truth won't die. And I don't mind what will happen. I've had three heart attacks. I have no children. So if they want to bring me to court or to prison, so it's worse for the truth.